Managing, transforming, and delivering cloud content using workflows. Can we do all that for media services? Absolutely. Using Azure Media Services, and I'm gonna tell you all about it, coming up now. Hello, everybody. My name is Adam Gordon, an edutainer here at ITProTV, back with another episode in our ongoing conversation around what is Azure, where we look at different services, features, and capabilities on the Microsoft Azure platform, and we use three specific questions to frame our conversation, really help you to understand the ideas behind them so you can decide whether or not they make sense for you. We talk about what the service is, we talk about why it may be important, why ultimately it makes sense for you and your organization to consider using it, and of course, how you can deploy it and put it to work for you. Let's begin by jumping in and talking about what is the Azure Media Service. When we think about Azure Media Services, we really have to step back. We have to consider ourselves, myself, you, any of us, how we consume media today. Most of us probably use streaming media more often than not, and probably have for a long time. You're watching me right now over a streaming media platform. You may be watching me on YouTube. You certainly may be familiar with ITProTV and may actually use us as a training provider. And you may watch me and my fellow edutainers helping you to understand technology all the time. ITProTV is also a media streaming provider. And as a result of those kinds of interactions, most of us today are very familiar with what media streaming is. But when we think about what Azure Media Services are, we have to step back and realize that it's not just about streaming one or two videos to people that may or may not be present at a meeting and have to watch them on replay, but we're talking about enterprise global spanning scale for media streaming distribution and the ability not only to scale that content, but the ability to deliver that content to various customers and endpoints of all sorts of types. We have Apple, right? We have Android, we have Google, and of course, Mozilla Firefox, not to mention, of course, Microsoft. Any kind of technology platform that we decide to consume from as a customer can receive these media service elements and ultimately can help our end users, our customers, become better informed and use our content, and hopefully as a result, help our company to survive and thrive. So the what is global capabilities to scale and ultimately to stream media to anywhere on the planet and to any kind of customer using any kind of platform. When we think about the why, we want to think about not just customer flexibility and certainly choice, but we want to think about security, we want to think about best-of-breed technology, we want to think about cutting-edge artificial intelligence, machine learning, and the ability to recognize content and make it available in a variety of different ways. Hypothetically, let's just say that I created some sort of video, whatever that content is, and maybe that content, we'll represent it with our content element right over here, is gonna be a 5-minute video, a streaming video of me presenting this exact content to you right now. Now, during this content, I'm using elements on the lightboard. I'm saying a variety of things to you, and things are popping up on the screen. Like, for instance, those three questions we started the episode with. What is it? Why is it important? And how do you use it? The artificial intelligence and the machine learning algorithms, the capabilities that are available to us in Azure Media Services allow deep introspection, deep analysis of that data, and allow us to take that information and make it available to customers in all sorts of new and innovative ways. We could have facial recognition. You could be searching for and saying, I want to find anything that Adam is in. I want to find this face, match it, and I want to see all that video content. And Azure Media Services can do that. I want to be able to recognize written text. Let's say that I wrote out, as I did, the word customers right here, and I want to be able to say that anytime the word customers appeared, I want to pull that information, and I want to be able to make it available and create a playlist. We can do that. Maybe I want to stream that content to various endpoints. I want to have a variety of content, but I want to do so securely using DRM, data rights management protection, so that way my content, my intellectual property, your business's bread and butter is going to be protected using state-of-the-art best-of-breed security so that as we stream it out and make it available to our customers across all these different platforms, we can reliably understand that they'll access this content, but they'll do so in a secure way. getting access to content they've paid for, they've licensed, and or we want them to see for free, but to do so in secure ways. So as we think about the why, I want to think about all these different elements, how they come together. And by the way, it's not just our video content that we can stream, but it's all sorts of assets. Maybe it is meetings that we record. Maybe it's the PowerPoint slide decks that go with them. Maybe it's the transcripts of that. Maybe it's any and all of those things put together, sent to any of those endpoints on any of these platforms securely using, as I said, best of breed encryption and data rights management technology to embed and ultimately protect our intellectual property. And while we're at it, we're going to use multi-factor authentication to ensure that customers are able to get that content, but to keep the people that don't belong seeing it if they need to pay for it out, and to ensure that only authorized users are using the platform. Any and all of this is available to us in Azure Media Services. We've answered the what, we've talked about the why. Most importantly, we still have the how left to go. And in order to show you how all this comes together, how easy it is to be able to create the initial onboarding for the Azure Media Services, create the media account, and get set up, we're going to take a look at the portal, and I'm going to show you how to do this coming up right now. Hello, everybody. We're in the how portion, looking at our Azure portal, about ready to jump in and see how we create our Azure Media Services account. I'm going to start by searching for the media services in the all services area. We're in the marketplace. We can find any sorts of services that we want here. You can see a variety of them already listed over there under featured. Once we see that link, we'll click on it. We'll be taken to the media services area. We've already taken the liberty of creating a media services account for us to use. It takes several minutes to stand up the account and get it working. I'll quickly run you through the wizard, showing you how we would add one. Then we're going to jump in and actually spend a couple of minutes looking under the hood at the features and capabilities that media services account gives us, all the elements that we talked about at the lightboard as we examine the answers to the why and the what questions. All right, so let's get started. We're going to go ahead and type in the word media here. We'll go ahead and we'll search. And when you see we do that, I'll just zoom in so you can see what that brings up. We see media services there, the only element. So we'll go ahead, we'll click on that. We do see our media services information here. We see our Courtney One account. That's the account we're going to use in just a couple of minutes. I'm going to click on that add button because normally there would be nothing here. We'd have to start by creating our own account. So let's click add. We're going to have a very simple wizard we're going to follow through here. What we get is the ability, just scroll down so we could see that, we get the ability here to start with project details, specifying our subscription information, a resource group. We want to put all of the elements associated with the storage account, for instance, the endpoint for streaming, as well as the actual media services account. All three of those are going to be created inside this resource group and associated together. We can use an existing one by pulling down on the right-hand side there, or use the link to create new. Same thing with the media services account details. You'll see right over there as we go through, we do have to provide a media services account name. It must be unique. We do have to provide a location. What geography and data center do we want to use this service through? Anywhere in the world where Azure services are available. And then storage account, it's going to be the backing element. It's going to allow us to upload all of our content, all of our assets, as we talked about at the lightboard, and make them available so we can stage them and stream them out. Think of those as your MP3 files, your meeting recordings, your PowerPoint slide decks, all that stuff you want to make available. All that has to be stored somewhere, and all that's going to go into one or more storage accounts. Again, either use existing by pulling down, or use the link there when it becomes available and create a new storage account. And then finally, down at the bottom of the page here, let's just scroll down so you could see that, we do have an option to opt in and either enable the classic APIs. If we do that, we get what are known as the classic V2, version 2 APIs. Base functionality, very important, but advanced security and features are going to become unavailable if we check that box off. Specifically, one of the most important, the managed identity capability that we see right below on advanced settings. And that managed identity is going to be system managed for us, meaning it is going to be created, it being the account that will be created, in the Azure Active Directory. It'll be stored there, managed by Azure, and made available to provide services and capabilities as we look to link the media services account and the streaming capabilities it provides to lots of other things like web applications and or services and APIs that we want to consume, turn around and make available through the platform. So we're going to make our choices here. And then finally, once we've done all that, right at the very bottom here, We do need to just see that we can opt in, and indeed we do have to check off that box. It says, I have all the rights to use the content and or file. The content is the asset that we're going to upload. So all those meeting recordings, all the MP3s, the videos, the music, the PowerPoints, et cetera, all that stuff. And that we're going to be able to say to Microsoft on the honor system, it's our stuff. We have the right to make it available, and we're doing so legally. So we're opting in there. We click review and create. We get a validation screen. Once we're validated, we click go ahead. It takes 2 to 3 minutes to stand up the account and get it all set and ready to go. Let's assume we've done all that because we're not going to wait for that to happen. We're going to go over here to resource groups, and I'm going to come down here, just highlight it as we zoom in. I've already got my resource group, the media resource group, where I've created the media services account, the backing storage account, and the streaming endpoint, the three objects that are created as part of the outcome of that wizard and that process. We'll click through, and we do see right over here that all of them are available, and we can see they're in the East US, where they would have been by default if we ran through the wizard. We're going to spend a couple of minutes now examining what's actually in that media services account, what's in that Courtney One account that we want to see. But the storage account, as I called out and suggested, and our streaming endpoint are available there, and they will be there and made available for us as part of the outcome of the process we just walked through. Let's click on that media services account. We'll see that we bring it up. And aside from the overview area and just the basic information about it, the fact that it is active and the fact that it is available to us in our subscription location, et cetera, we do have then the ability to do access control, to look at logging, but we're much more interested in the areas below there, the areas that have to do with settings, as well as the ability, we'll just zoom in so you could see that, to deal with media services right below. We could set up encryption, talk about the new advanced security and capabilities using AES-based encryption, best of breed, as well as, remember, DRM, digital rights management, to protect our intellectual property. Those elements are available to us here under settings. Our storage account is there, one or more, depending on what we're doing, where we can actually see our content and our assets and interact with them. So all those elements are brought together here. And then below, we see our media services. Let's just bring that front and center. Let's make sure we can see that nicely in the screen as we zoom in. We have API access. It's where we can add and interact with multiple APIs, bringing in different services and capabilities from all different areas of the Azure platform. We have our assets area. That's where we can actually upload and provide those assets, those streaming media files, those PowerPoint files, et cetera, and then ultimately make them available. So it's a simple upload area where we click on upload, we select the file type, and ultimately the place it's from that we add it in winds up in our storage account. We're then able to use it. We have our content policies. We have our transforms and jobs. We have the ability to set up live streaming, as well as look at and monitor and interact with streaming endpoints. Any and all of these features are part of the media services solution. All of these, by the way, are things that will have to be configured. There is some complexity associated with doing this, but rest assured, we can make that complexity relatively straightforward by walking through and understanding how to use all of this. I do a job on all that and much more for you around all this kind of content over at ITProTV. You can watch all the Azure content I have there as one of the edutainers. People that I work with, all the other edutainers on our team, are also going to provide a lot of that content for you, where we break down these complex services and spend the time walking through them end to end for you to show you how to implement them. We just did a quick high-level flyby here. We go a lot more in depth. So I always encourage you, as I do at the end of every one of our episodes, to take a walk with me. Take it on over to ITProTV, check us out, and if you find value in what we're doing, subscribe. You can use our content, we can spend more time together, and I can show you the really cool things you can do with Azure, top to bottom. I'm going to wish you happy Azuring until I come back with another episode, and until then, I'll see you soon.